Temperature, humidity, and air pressure all affect air density. Denser air creates more resistance for the golf ball. The greater the air density, the more lift and drag. This means greater air density results in shots that fly higher, land steeper, and carry shorter. And although wind and altitude have much larger effects on distance, changes in the weather can result in noticeable gains and losses. As elevation increases, air pressure decreases. But for a given location, weather patterns will create small changes in air pressure. High pressure systems increase air density and low pressure systems decrease density. However, the differences are unlikely to create a noticeable change in your ball flight. Normal changes in air pressure will result in less than 1 yard difference in distance. Did you know that higher humidity will make the ball fly farther? Even though humid air may feel heavier, the molecular weight of water is less than that of dry air, which consists primarily of nitrogen and oxygen. So higher humidity decreases air density. Even though humidity does affect air density, going from 10% to 90% has negligible effects on distance. That extreme change in humidity would add less than 1 yard to a mid-trajectory 6-iron and just over 1 yard to an optimized drive. Temperature changes will have the greatest effect on distance. Going from 40 degrees Fahrenheit to 100 will increase a mid-trajectory 6-iron by almost 8 yards and the driver by 9. That is a little more than 1 yard per 10 degrees Fahrenheit. This distance increase is only due to temperature's effect on air density. Other factors, such as the amount of clothes worn, increased muscle flexibility, or elasticity of the golf ball, could make this distance increase even larger. Low air pressure, high humidity, and hot temperatures will result in a combination of weather conditions that decrease air density and make the ball fly lower and farther. However, even in extreme cases, do not expect this added distance to result in more than a club difference.